Use code DATTO10 at logi.gg/datto to save money on your next order from Logitech. Links are in the description, and they should actually work now. My bad. Malfeasance got a catalyst this season. It gives the gun Vorpal weapon. Should you grind out 700 kills to go get it? Let's discuss. Malfeasance has always been one of those guns that is always teetering on the verge of being a really strong weapon. Some would argue that even before the catalyst that it was a top tier primary weapon. It is one of the higher damage dealing primary weapons in the entire game, although definitely not at the top. But the benefit that it has is that it doesn't need any sort of ramp up effect like Outbreak Perfected or a proc to get going like Taraba, other than just hitting your shots. You hit 5 shots on a target, and you deal some explosive damage to the target after you do that. Another benefit is being able to deal decent damage from really far away, as the explosions don't have any damage fall off since your shots are attached to the enemy. And this weapon got a bit of attention due to the fact that hunters were using it to solo Nezarek, which I will remind you is a raid boss. Primary weapon damage is something I have rarely cared about as we have grown more powerful. Highest damage primary is like saying that I was the best player at a basketball tournament for nerds. It's cool. I'm still not getting in the NBA. The only times I see Outbreak busted out is for day one raid experiences in emergencies. So while I have thought Malfeasance is a cool weapon capable of putting out some decent damage, when the entire point of the weapon is to use it a lot, but it's not better than something like a special or a power weapon, then my interest starts to wane because I know I'm not really being efficient. In low and mid-tier content, that's fine, but in higher tier content, you wanna be efficient. And after running some endgame content with this weapon, well, my main gripe has not changed. I ran my Strand Titan endgame build and just rotated in Malfeasance with a ton of kinetic mods and surges. I'm just all in on the weapon's performance. My issue with Malfeasance is the same as it was pre-nerf. Nothing has really changed there. This is a gun that you want to use the majority of the time that you're using it because of how it works. It also has a Vorpal now, which we mainly want to use on boss targets, although there is some utility against vehicles which can come in handy on rare occasion. My response to why I wouldn't want to use Malfeasance is that machine guns still literally exist. Since Lightfall, I have said that you should only be using machine guns until they get some kind of adjustment because they are just that good, outside of a raid or dungeon boss damage situation, something like that. I'm not gonna lie, in this quick test that I show, things are pretty darn close. Machine gun wins, but not by a dramatic margin. But this is without killing tally active, which would have given the machine gun a bit of an edge. I can understand wanting something that gets pretty close to machine gun damage without having to commit power ammo to such a cause though. Could this replace a machine gun in a lesser way, allowing you to use a different heavy weapon like a GL or a rocket or something? Sure, something like an explosive light rocket can help with champion or boss damage, giving you an extra chunk of damage as you switch back to your primary weapon. If you don't have a good machine gun or one capable of some sort of a damage buff, then obviously Malfeasance gains considerable value. I'd much rather see someone on a catalyst-enabled Malfeasance shooting at a champion versus any generic legendary primary or poorly rolled machine gun. But if you have a top-of-the-line machine gun, I think you can pretty much carry on as normal. My testing in a Master Nightfall, which is 20 levels under, ended up just being more of the same. I was using it in places where I would normally be using my machine gun, and I didn't really feel more effective than if I just kept using a machine gun. Keep in mind that even though I can stack all of these kinetic mods on my gear, I can just as easily do the same for my machine gun. And with stuff like Aeons and Cenotaph, or a double special loadout, or maybe any sort of season perk that comes along, heavy ammo is just ubiquitous in group-based content. So, that's a wrap on Malfeasance then, right?
Wrong!
Unless you're a Titan or a Warlock, then yeah, that's pretty much it for you. But Hunters, maybe you were wondering, how How?
Some people are capable of soloing Nezarek with the use of this weapon. Why hunters? Why not everyone? Well, it has to do with an old exotic, Lucky Pants. This exotic got a big buff a long time ago that still didn't really create that much fanfare. But let's really go over what it does to understand why it's so potent with Malfeasance. Lucky Pants procs when you ready a fully loaded hand cannon that either deals kinetic damage or a damage type matching your subclass. Each hit will make the next shot after it deal bonus damage, in addition to giving hand cannons a bunch of non-damage boosts. You get 60% bonus damage per hit, maxing out at 600% after 10 hits, with the buff lasting 5.5 seconds. After that, the effect goes on cooldown for 10 seconds, which is called out of luck. Now, unfortunately, the explosions generated from hitting a target 5 times with Malfeasance shots does not gain the benefit from the bonus damage, along with many other special hand cannon effects. Otherwise, you probably would have heard about this sooner rather than later. But that doesn't mean the effect is not good on Malfeasance, because it is. This combination in particular is what can help you eliminate champions or even stuff like master lost sector bosses in record speeds, faster than most power weapons can kill these targets. And this is something I can get behind a lot more, because doing things in this manner is more efficient than using a machine gun when it comes to raw killing power. I don't feel stupid for using Malfeasance in this way when I can take down pretty much any champion in my way in a handful of hand cannon shots and a proc of my exotic that I completely control. This combo isn't anything really that new, but it's probably not something you've really seen a whole lot of. Malfeasance gains benefits over other hand cannons because of 2 reasons. Vorpal Weapon, which is the catalyst, and because it's a 180 RPM hand cannon. Vorpal is normally a perk I completely ignore nowadays because there are just better options out there. On power weapons, it's only 10%, and on primary weapons, well, I don't want a boss damage perk on a primary weapon because it's rare I'll be using that weapon on a boss unless I literally have nothing else to use. And Malfeasance being a 180 RPM hand cannon means you can get to the maximum damage benefit faster and shoot more shots at the highest multipliers compared to 140 or 120 RPM hand cannons, where you're just barely getting to that max damage shot in time. I even have time to aim Malfeasance to proc unstoppable hand cannon and get to the maximum damage shots. I don't need to waste a bunch of damage on an unstunned unstoppable first. For example, I tried out a well-rolled Fatebringer, and that did maybe half of an unstop's health. Impressive for a legendary primary, but nothing compared to Malfeasance. Then I tried Ace of Spades to see if there was a big difference there, and while it is also capable of taking out champions in a single magazine, it doesn't do it as quickly, nor is it as forgiving. Both of these tests were with Kinetic Surge times 3, much like I'm using on Malfeasance. This turns the catalyst from a novelty into something you should give some serious consideration when it comes to pure champion killing power. Now, in group content, is this a cool effect to have? Sure. Do I think it's nearly as valuable? Not necessarily, and that's because you have other teammates who can contribute. If everyone is contributing equally, then most champions go down without much effort. But if you're in a situation where you maybe need to carry some people, someone's not pulling their weight, and you need a more guaranteed way to take down certain champions, then this is absolutely something to consider running, especially with Strand Hunter having so many ways to suspend champions. Unfortunately, you can't really out DPS and overload's health regeneration on the highest difficulties, but in some easier stuff or closer to at level stuff, it can totally happen. So, should you go grind out that Malfeasance catalyst? If you're a hunter and you're willing to mess around with Lucky Pants to burn down some champions in a handful of shots, I would say yeah. If you're anything else, then I'd say at this moment in time, probably not that important unless you're a Malfeasance enthusiast in which case you probably already have it. If it ever becomes more efficient than power weapons for killing champions, you're gonna wanna have it around, but until then, just enjoy your machine gun. Thanks for watching, I'll see you next time.